All right, welcome back from that short break. You're still watching Abend to the Radio on Abend Television. Remember, you can get in touch with us on our social media pages. For Facebook, Abend TV, and of course, for Twitter, it is at Abend TV Uganda. Coming back to tea at 7. Now, this is a very interesting one, so you need to open up your ears. Apparently, there are fake family planning pills on the market. We're getting into the holy month. We need to be very holy. Of course, these family planning pills are going to depreciate in terms of consumption. Which is
what? How does money
have to call a spade a spade?
How does that even how?
You know, when people are in the holy month and they're not married or they have not done the one I was talking about,
nikah,
you're not supposed to, you know, have sexual intercourse. It's a sin.
It's a sin everywhere to just have sexual intercourse
when you're not married.
So for you, in this month.
This month you have a problem.
No, what I'm saying, there is something
so have you
this
been
month.
Conquering in the Muslim world?
Let's say I have been conquered in the Muslim world.
Let us talk about Postinor in peace. I'm sorry.
Derek, let us leave the Muslim things alone. You will shoot yourself.
But that's one thing I need to understand. I need to have a conversation. When I saw your buzzer in Ramadan, but I need to understand, Katim. When I have a Muslim girlfriend,
no,
it's a girlfriend. We've been in a relationship, and for some reason, Bambi, I've been even playing, praying to God. God, Bambi, nyamba, let me marry this, you know, Fatuma. Let me marry this Rashida.
Zaitun.
Bambi, njagala kwela serious.
Rashida.
Good morning, love. I miss you. Adamu.
Inshallah.
Farouk, Adamu, when I love Farouk,
you are allowed to, you can express your love.
But she's not allowed to express.
No, you can't express.
What if reciprocates?
You can actually, because Allah knows for a fact, you're going to, if she's the one and you're serious, okay, no more from this. So she can say, I love you too, and have a good day.
By the way, as a Mukafiri or a Christian or whatever, please, let's resist from tempting our Muslim brothers and sisters.
It's going to be hard.
Yeah, it's only fair that you...
I'm just saying, it's going to be hard.
Katigwe, Aina Rashida, you want to send Rashida I love in the morning for what?
It's going to be hard. I think I broke that already. It's hard.
Mwanabi wa mwezechi. Don't let him know.
I told you guys, my Muslim friends are too neat. I don't know how to... Kwanza kumachana ngende nenda andikisa chigambo chiri echi nene. Kwabunde nene. Nangamba ti. Abana ba parking ze mwe wa nere ze be wabo.
But in the light of this passing season, that a new vision under the editor Kawesa got out this Copa Coca-Cola thing, I'd like to send, you know, my strength to strengthen students from Chibuli SS, students from Adneda Shitofu Siva Sidam. But I think Chibuli SS and other, you know, Islam schools, Kawempe SS, Mukama Abagumi.
Can we go back to the Postinor now?
Auntie Postinor, to you masome.
Are you kidding?
No, we need to face the truth, by the way.
Why are we focusing on only Postinor? There are very many family planning pills. What you
that are
birth control pills?
No. You need to
direction.
He has clearly bought a few, eh?
No, in the summer.
It's okay.
Told you family planning pills
primary.
Yes. During the reproductive.
So, did they tell you about the pills, the IUDs?
Yes.
Which one in particular are you conversant
in primary?
Yes.
First, wait.
Reproduction. Yeah. I remember it was chapter 9 of the science lessons.
Yes. So which ones in particular are you conversant with? The morning after,
there's
the IUD, the coil?
There's the injector plan. That's the injection.
That's an IUD.
Yes.
P what?
No, the injection.
Okay.
P what?
P7.
Okay.
P7, P6 are around there. Then there is the one. For, then oxygen. Then what you know? Javasala or Gundi, Vegetabatia, Javas, Mangrain, Javasala.
That's a permanent situation.
Aha, that's a permanent situation. Mm. Then there's also the birth control pills. Mm. Then there's the Postina. Yeah, Postina, the Vajib Summit Safar by Jesuum Burida.
Baba Samesaka Majani.
But let me tell you,
we're going
to contraception, but we'll get to that later.
Ogamila Mumizi.
Come. I'm just saying. This is like literally every young person's nightmare. You know, because most of you young people believe that contraception has got your back, like we can fool around, play around without, you know, having obligation and responsibility. Because, you know, in the morning, just for how much is it?
Enough discharge, man.
Oh, okay. For a small amount of money, you know, you can.
No, but the truth is, Postina is 8K.
I'm just saying. So to imagine you've had your pare, your lead, you've done what it is that you've done. You know, Postina got my back tomorrow morning. Ah, men are very vigilant in the morning. They wake up first thing, they're like, babe.
Precaution is better than cure.
They come with the glass and everything. But imagine her walking away, you thinking you have it all together, and then she calls you and she's like, you know what? Something is off. First thing that's going to happen, now this is where the confusion...
That is the line you use.
I don't know who. I have
for the last three times, that's the line you've used.
No.
Something is off.
No. Me, I was in a real situation, my dear. We were not taking any birth control.
Yes, but how did you get the news?
They were pregnant.
But you said something is off.
No, that is what the slay queens you guys are always with.
Which guys?
Anyway, and then she calls you and she tells you... First thing that hits your mind is like, that ain't my baby. Because I gave you that medicine, I was seated with you. And then she's also going to think probably you're denying her. And then it's going to become a back and forth. And the baby's going to grow up in an unwanted situation because none of you was ready, you know, to have to...
No, because someone imported fake pills.
Yeah, not us not being ready.
First we had planned not to have.
Not to have. That's why we took the pill.
But then someone imported
fake pills. Now, the biggest question here should be, how do we differentiate the fake pills from the real
pills? We need us a doctor.
No. I think that in the
there
first
must
place,
be like a litmus
test. Why are you doing grown-up people things?
If you're not ready for grown-up people responsibilities.
It's family planning.
Which
family do you have and what are you planning
which
for?
Which family?
I am planning for the...
Kati gwenera sida mwina family.
Hey!
So I think that in the first case, as young people, as we young people, you know, you're not ready, you don't have savings in your account, you don't have a job.
What are you doing having mindset?
Family planning?
No, which family? Which family?
You are planning for which the actual family.
Actually, you don't get it. Let me break it down for him.
Family, as in family.
They are actually put in place for people who are ready.
If that's a case in point, then let government ban these Postinors or something.
What? No. For us, the ones who have families are trying to plan for them.
Actually, me, I think that people in pharmacies, people in the health sector, need to come and survey the situation. Instead of saying they are fake pills and you can tell a fake from an original, why are you telling a 20-year-old how to tell to differentiate a fake and an original?
Because a 20-year-old is mature enough to give
Let someone present their
natural ID. If you're mature enough to give birth, then don't ask for contraception. Yes. Go give birth.
There's a difference between being mature enough to give birth and being mature enough to take care of this baby boy or baby girl.
Oh, no, baby boy. It always starts with when you spread them legs. I don't know why people think that accepting a child and obligation is when the baby comes. No. Accepting a child and the obligations and responsibility of having a baby starts the moment you say, hey, your baby.
Even pleasure also starts when you open the legs.
And that's where all your problems
you can't handle.
What do you mean I can't handle?
You're at campus. You're at campus in second year, third year. And you're a girl. In your head, why do you think that your pleasure costs 10K?
Thank you.
I mean, it may cost about 20K. That depends on what other measures are used. Oh, by the way, I also forgot about the condoms. They're also part of the family control.
What?
Yeah.
The first thing that we need to understand is that pharmacies need to ask for national IDs of people. When someone comes to buy contraception.
So what, when a 23-year-old show up and she's at campus without a plan, you're going to be like, no, we shall not be giving you.
What, you're 22, why are you
paying for family No, we got you. Here's the thing, though. We're looking for a solution. It's all right. It's okay. If there's fake Postinor and all of that contraception on the market, it's okay.
No, it's not okay.
No, no contraception has come to.
Who said? Child has been satisfied.
No, it's going to be here by, and actually some hospitals.
So we're going to anjaga first in Uganda.
There are actually some private hospitals that have it.
As a guy out there, you go and buy male contraception.
That's it.
It is still on test.
Exactly.
You will get defaults like the ones we got with Samsung phones.
You see?
Your carrot
has been banned. I'm not a feminist. What is so wrong? You people don't understand.
That's
what we deserve. That is true. But we're talking about male contraception here. Do you know that one Postinor you give a girl in the morning takes and stays in her body with hormonal effects for up to 2 months?
I know. Get my point.
They mess us up.
Tina, you did not get my point.
Now, what I am saying, since ours is a fake, let us wait for them to certify yours.
And then, what is saying. Police is not against the fact that men should not
take contraception. Would you take male contraception?
Yes, but listen.
Would you?
After it has been certified.
Male contraception is going to take about 15 years.
Yes. To be certified.
Why can't they just give every guy steroids so that he can shoot blanks? That has been working so well.
Then after, when you want to reverse and have children?
Get off the steroids. So that your sperm can go back up.
Then you take about 20 years.
No, it's not 20 years.
These are things God searched down.
You know how much I love to have babies. I decided to take it upon my time to understand reproduction.
I would say this, that as a guy out
you can actually have sterile sperm.
Do not be excited about male contraception. Do not go for male contraception right now.
It's
still under test. However, you can start having the conversation with your would-be wife, now Derek, like Rashida, or Fatuma. Now, me like other people, I can also begin having the conversation. But you don't go for male contraception.
With the
on the other hand,
there's a piece.
He's
not a pee guy.
He's
not
been
a pee guy.
You'll be shocked. Passive.
Passive.
Those are guys, not dog names, but by example.
Those are dog names. Can you listen? For me, I'll say this. Government ain't no
violate. This conversation is so random.
Government ain't no violate to Yambe. In maternity wards and women's hospitals, they should come out and put this information there that a fake pill looks like this, an original pill looks like this.
But they do that? You haven't been to a maternity ward, have you?
Why would I? I haven't. Okay. And then the other thing should be.
Then don't say it.
Yeah, the other thing should be, Minister of Health should come through and preach against selling pills to people who are underage. People whose age looks like they cannot have families.
What underage?
Because
according
to the Ugandan law, if one clocks 18, you are an adult.
You're above age.
Yes, but there's age, there's consenting age. There's age to make decisions. There's age for family.
According to this country,
age of alcohol is 21. Age of a bar is 21. You know, there are different agents. To drive a trailer, you're given a permit.
I have made an advert of alcohol. Yes. Alcohol is not for sale to persons under the age of 18.
There's 21. There's alcohol of 21.
Which
you
one?
Will see.
Which one?
Njaji kula watu vude kushu.
Kati ngoma nye yabanyarwanda.
And then there's age of driving a trailer, which is 35.
Yes, that one. Because they calculate the amount, the number of, what is it, permits you have gotten in between, because you're supposed to upgrade from permit to permit.
No,
calculate it,
no,
you almost...
That is one of the reasons, but the main reason age is because below 35, you're making reckless decisions. At 30, you can decide to say, but at 35, you have children, you're responsible.
So basically, I'm sitting with a bunch of undecided...
You're not
at 35.
Are you sure?
Neither are you. Don't even assure I was there for your last birthday party. I put cake in your face.
You wrote the wrong age.
No, we did not.
Where was I?
You were there.
We are.
They are.
So for me, another thing we should look out for is the pharmacies. Pharmacies are not being audited properly.
They have not been audited in a long time.
So we have pharmacies selling not for sale drugs, and that is where the
I had the worst experience on Friday. So on Friday, on Friday I leave this place and I'd caught a bag. I wasn't feeling fine, so I got to
because of the Postinor. Let's continue the story.
Have you dimwits met my three beautiful kids? That clearly states I'm not afraid to have babies if I want to.
Doesn't
babies.
Mean that
thank
you're
you.
Not afraid of using Postinor as well.
I cannot use them. I'm a chunky babe. They make me funny. So I go to this hospital and then they tell me, okay, this is what you're going to get, these are the drugs, blah blah blah. Now I'm like, Mulina pharmacy, because I did everything. I'm like, and then they go and tell me, they're like, our pharmacy is not open at the time because it was it. But there's a string of pharmacies on this route. They wrote the prescription. Give it to me. Now I get there, I give the woman the prescription. You know how those guys only understand their language? Pharmacists and doctors have a strange relationship. They understand each other. So she gets all the medication, gives it to me. I go home. I'm still actually dealing with the side effects up to now. I go home, take the tabs. And then I catch this weird, heartburn. It kept going, It wasn't nausea. It kept going. So I call my doctor, at about 3 in the morning. He's like, what medicine did they give you? I'm like, let me WhatsApp you. I send photos of my meds, and he's like, they gave you absolutely what you weren't supposed to take. So when you say that pharmacies need to honestly be regulated, I almost lost my life over the weekend because of that. They really, really need... who is in charge of pharmacies?
Dr. Cheng. But you see, there was also a conversation. A conversation of doctors should stop writing poorly.
No, that's not going to change.
It will change. Me, when I'm in front of a doctor, I think I should start doing it. My friend, write properly before.
I need to know what ails me.
Strange but true. When you talk about Dr. Wengolong, I want to listen with
me. Yeah.
But anyway, away from that, of course, we want to get a quick look at our Is That So? It's coming in this particular morning. Now, apparently, the average person spends 6 months of their lifetime waiting on the red light to turn green. 6 months of my lifetime. This is a long time.
Someone needs to get those lights out.
Me, whenever I'm driving, I try to avoid places that have those lights.
So that you don't spend the 6 months?
Yeah. When I die, people will calculate my time on the red lights as probably 1 month. But okay. I think I've run. This is anyway. This is a TV show. It will not be used against me in a court of law. I have run about 3 or 4 red lights in my entire life. How many have you run?
This idiot runs them all the time.
Am I always driving with you? One of me have never run any. I always wait 6 months. I may even be in 7. I don't know how people lie. How next is that? Apparently, a broken clock is right 2 times every day. The way I feel like I'm
going to talk.
That's the problem with Africans.
For about 4 months, and it was hard for people to actually understand that watch wasn't working. It was broken. And it didn't have that.
Problem in Africa. You are smart.
I am one of the 90 people.
Who do what?
90% of Ugandans in Kampala whose watches are never fixed.
Like you have, yeah, take water. Yes. You never ask Willis for the time. Never. Let us go in for a very quick break. But when we do get back, Nicholas will be joining us for an update of what happened in the world of sports. All right, are you still watching Urban Today? Right here on Urban Television, we are getting into some sports and news for you, and we would like to find out what is happening on the local and international scene. Nicholas is joining us for that update. Good morning to Nicholas.
Another fine week of May, the month of May 2019, of course, our week number two, the days of our lives. The weather looks quite handsome outside.
Okay.
I don't know whether you dudes have actually you haven't, because we're here by half six.
Yeah,
it was still dark. Sorry.
How is it outside?
It's actually, the sun is out. One of those very beautiful, you know, sunsets. So,
Sunsets?
Yeah, sunset, yeah.
Sunset
or sun?
Whatever it is.
Yeah, let's talk about the language that you do understand more than anyone right here. Willis, you wanted to give us some facts regarding sports this morning?
I picked on something there, by the way. Most of these dudes in the Ugandan Cranes actually channel through the Coca-Cola. We are embracing the 27th edition this week. Urban TV alongside Bukire TV will actually be airing the finals live. That's next week in Jinja, via Jinja College. For some of us were actually in Bugembe yesterday. We attended a service ceremony with the Honorable Speaker of Parliament. But anyway,
yes. Wanted to check his attitude towards you.
No, it's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay.
But you can confirm that she's okay.
She's fine, Bam. She's doing well. She's still a bit weak, but she actually came out to condemn all those political leaders who come through, who come to power, promise what they claim to promise, and then for some reason or the other, they just don't deliver. It's like those, she's a certain word to define who they are, but yeah, she's like, those people should be dejected the next time out. Of course, that's 2021. Yes.
Are you voting this time around?
I voted the last time out, so that's a definite yes.
So you're voting again?
Just obviously, there's so much insecurity going around the country. Our very own is being threatened, but you see those things are just...
Who is being threatened?
Our very own is being threatened.
You and who?
When I say our, I mean the reason as to why you wake up every morning safe in your kadukuru, or in your car room, not kadukuru, kadukuru is probably for the criminals. Yeah, in your room, it's the reason as to why we all wake up every morning.
They are threatened by him. He's not being threatened by anyone.
No, for me, the reason I wake up every morning in my kadukuru is because of God. No one else.
But you see, God puts leaders. To lead us. That is why I think across the world we have prime ministers, kings, and presidents. So, yes.
What type of coffee did you drink with the Honorable Speaker of Parliament?
Let us talk about the UPL. Just as they came out to be current champions, of course, we did see this happening after their, previous game that did happen with them.
Well, the weekend did have the Uganda Premier League, of course, come to an end. Match day 30 across the country. It was gold raining through, especially for the game right there, where KCFC were crowned champions for the 13th time, putting six past Prison Club side in Maroons FC over David Uwan. I must point out the fact that KCFC, without a doubt, have been deserved champions. They came out, capitalized on a Vipers faltering against URA and crowned rather declared champions with only three games to spare. It's been a side that has been convincing, especially the manner in which they've managed to actually win the UPL, whereby their top scorer has been a midfielder. That is Muzabin Mutiaba right there. Kadu Patrick as well, sharing the responsibility of getting the goals. Mike Mutiaba has actually seen this club side right from grassroots. What I mean by grassroots is the fact that he actually has managed to blend in youngsters with the matures in Mike Sulaiman Mutiaba. It's been a side that have come out to showcase character. They've been fearless all through the entire season. Yes, they've had their downfalls, failing to defend the Uganda Cup title, and also failing to reach the CAF Confederations Cup group stages. But without a doubt, they've actually come out and given us some good footballing moments, especially as far as the Uganda Premier League is concerned, with Mike Mutebi witnessing another league title in what should be a very memorable and cherishable outing for those youngsters and also those big, big mature men on match there. But it was a 6-1 finish from KCCFC. Patrick Kadu scoring a brace on 11 and on 37 minutes respectively. Muzamiru Mutyaba getting on the score sheet as well, their top scorer this season, alongside Sulaiman Mutyaba and Alan Okello, Alan Chamba Debate, all getting on the score sheet for Kampala Capital City Authority Football Club side, who were crowned champions for the 13th time in their footballing history. When you look elsewhere, more goals came out, because then Bright Stars also convincingly saw out Pied the Black Angels, who already got relegated from the UPL as they prepared to, prepare for life back in the big league. Nelson Senkatuka scoring 5 on match day. Whether he remains at the club side, he has done extremely well for Bright Stars in Mwerere. For Pied the Black Angels, a record 21 defeats this season, along with Nyemi Tobara. That explains why they got the axe at the end of this season. Down in Jinja, where it was for the weekend, Kirinya did draw with Mindeja University in Bugembe, and also from Mbare City 2-0 winners over Police FC. Jude Semugari and Ivan Ayam getting on the score sheet for the Ankole Lions, who finished in fifth place for Police FC, ending their season with back-to-back defeats, three straight league defeats to be precise, for Police FC of Abudala Mubiru. Down in Chitende, Vipers also finished their campaign on a high, much as they failed to defend their title. A 1-0 victory against a junior club side in Bull FC, thanks to Brandon Kubi on 48 minutes, enough to bag all 3 points for the reigning champions in Vipers Sports Club. AC Villa, having survived relegation after Ndeje lost out to Ondu Paraka, they put 6 past already relegated club side in Nyamitobara. Ronald Maguari, Bias Wanji, Mike Serumaga scoring a breast, Semuju Mugisha, all joining the party for the 16th time league champions, who have a lot of homework on their hands as they go into preseason. Duparaka and Express FC failing to find the back of the net, both sides sharing the spoils in match day 30, while Toro and URA, which was the standard fixture, that game finished 0-0, both sides failing to cancel each other out, and both sides have had a very remarkable season. Both sides in URA and Toro are registering their best ever finish. That is how the Uganda Premier League ended on match day 30 over the weekend across the country. And I must say, for KCCFC, congratulations, as Mike Mutebi managed to guide KCCFC to their 13th league title.
Very disappointed in the trophy. Very disappointed in the manager.
How it looks like.
Yeah, how it looks like and how heavy it is for 30 days.
Well, you're gonna
for 30 days of playing football. Honestly, Uganda took Kuze. We need to just get away from the cups. Eh?
Mm.
We need to get something really.
We feel your pain. We the football, you know, followers. We feel your pain, because at the start of the season, over I think should have been 100 million plus was injected into the league by Star Times, the guys from China, I think.
Yes.
And you can imagine, I would think, get even if it's like what, 20 million.
Yes.
Tatuma here makes very good.
We could. I don't know where we would get
but
it.
But we have companies that. When you look at that trophy.
Where do we get this trophy from?
It's with. We
can even get a Ugandan. Probably, I don't know.
You've seen the Spanish La Liga. Okay, even that one doesn't look all that fancy. We've seen, I think the most prestigious one is the Champions League.
Yes.
It's made of silver. Inside has pure gold. It's something you know you'd want to go out there and play for and die for. But when you look at that, honestly, I wouldn't even fancy to take a selfie with it, by the way. But we've had it before here on the show, game on. It has so many scratches. Even the how do you call them? The label outs, the ones they use are not really properly laid out. So there's plenty of work required to be done on that trophy. But anyway, at the end of the day, KCC won't really care about it, because then they've been crowned champions. But when you look into the nitty-gritties, a lot of work needs to be done on that trophy.
Yeah. Mm.
Let us move on from football and talk about, of course, some basketball that did happen over the weekend. City Oilers are coming up to lose a game up against UCU right there.
Well, UCU gave Oilers quite a huge test over the weekend. Week number 4 in the National Basketball League. Oilers, the defending champions in the men's category, suffered their first defeat, 90-82. Finished an evenly out affair between the two sides, right from the first, the second, the third quarter. Not until Oilers somehow tired in the fourth quarter quarter, where USU managed to run away with the game 14-6. That was the margin, or that was the difference between the two sides in the fourth and final quarter, where Cannons came out to claim all maximum points, two to be precise, against the defending champions, who are without their coach, rather against the siding Oilers, with Mandy Jerini suffering his first defeat in their last 25 league games. That is how crucial that game was for Cannons, especially the manner in which they managed to get that win against the defending champions. Elsewhere, KA Titans got back to winning ways, spread to the win against JKL Dolphins, who are fresh from that stunner against Power, came out to claim the day 54-68 in favor of KA Titans, who registered their first win in their last three games on a game day yesterday down at the YMCA. Power also got back to winning ways, having suffered a shocker against JKL Dolphins. They claimed it a 66-43 against Our Savior. And in the women's, it was A1 Challenge that narrowly saw out KIU Rangers 56-54. That is how the NBL over the weekend unfolded, with Oilers suffering their first defeat as the Cannons came out to claim the victory.